how can someone Jamaican move into Rastafari? Because I think that as a foreigner, it's easier to move into Rastafari than if you are Jamaican and you're not born a Rasta. Because there's so much resistance, so much ignorance about what it is to really be a Rasta and the beauty and the love that it represents.
Congratulations to the three of you, Mr. Doctor, the financier who put it all together, producer. But I love you two sisters and will always praise you for this film. Thank you for including me in it. I am so honored. Bless you. Love.
Hi, I'm Joy Kelly from Cool FM, and I was touched watching the movie because a discovery of identity. And you spoke about being not just a Rastafarian, but also those two things being quite different experiences. My question to you is, because as I was watching it, it was almost as if we were going on the journey with you and seeing it and watching you be very vulnerable as you were doing it. And it seemed as though you were on a journey that could, it's a journey that we're all on in terms of self-identity and understanding our purpose and why we're here and what this is really all about. And I could see that theme echoed. But was there ever a moment when you felt this is too much, I'm too vulnerable, I'm putting myself out there too much, and I'm not comfortable? Right now.
What are you talking about, then or no? Right now. I mean, there were definitely moments. I come from a background, my first introduction to the stage, well, behind the stage, from behind the stage, was acting at 17, a theater. And so, theater taught me about humanity, because you had to empty your vessel to become a channel for someone else's story. And so it taught me that whenever you meet people, you have no idea what their story is, and so this moment can be very potent. It's either you heal or you hurt. And when I found myself like on camera with a camera in front of me all the time while experiencing so many emotions, this, you were talking about 6, 7, 8 years ago, a lot of things were happening with me emotionally. And I was vulnerable every day. I remember being in Israel and speaking to Gil Rasta. That was my birthday. And I was alone. Even though the crew was there, my family wasn't there. And it was the year that Mama B, my grandfather's mother, passed away. And I was thinking about all of these things. And I had a breakdown in the bathroom before going to interview him, just trying to get myself together and be ready to be present. So being present takes a lot. There are many things that we can say about it. So even in this moment, I feel like I'm being too vulnerable, you know? Because I'm also an activist, and I'm also fighting, and I'm also doing these things that are very important, but I'm also very human and experiencing the world in the same way that everyone else is, you know? So, yeah.